We'll solve Irodov problem 294, chapter 3, that is electrodynamics. In this problem, there is a loop placed in a magnetic field which is directed into the plane of paper, in this case into the plane of the board, and there is a conductor with a length A, that is radius of this loop, which is connected to a source providing EMF, and this conductor has a weight mg. And important point to note is that this axis is horizontal in horizontal plane. So because the axis is in the horizontal plane, the weight will produce a torque along the axis, and this will be in clockwise direction. So value of this torque will be equal to mg times this distance from the center of mass. This is A, this is A upon 2, and this is sine theta, so it will be A upon 2 sine theta into mg. So we should provide EMF which should be able to counter this torque. So the rotation should be, let us take, is in this direction. Because of this EMF, let there be a torque on the rod which would be equal to, first we should know what is the force acting on the rod at different points. This is the rod. Let us take a distance x from the center and dx part of the rod. Let the current be flowing through the rod in this direction. If the current is flowing in this direction, what is the movement? What will be the force which will act on the rod? Force is equal to I L cross B. If you take the side view of this, if we make the current flow like this, then this is the length in this direction you will have to take, and this is B. So this is L cross B would give the force in this direction, that is in the clockwise direction. So we should provide the source EMF such that current flows in this direction. If the current flows in this direction, and this is the value of B here, B is down, I am taking the side view, this is the side view. If you look at the conductor from the side, current is flowing like this. So L cross B would provide the force in this direction, so it has to move in this direction, that is what we want. So we provide positive here, negative here, and it rotates in the anti-clockwise direction. Now because of this current which is flowing, the force which is acting is equal to, as I have written there, I dx into B, and what will be the value of torque? D torque will be x times. Each element will produce a torque which will be x times the force. This is the value of force on each element. So total torque will be equal to IB x square by 2, which will be equal to IB A square upon 2 is the torque in the anti-clockwise direction. Now I is the current which is flowing through the conductor because of EMF. Now when this conductor is rotating, when this conductor starts rotating, there will be an induced EMF because of this rotation, and the induced EMF will be such that it will oppose the motion. So the force has to act in this direction. So the direction of the induced current will be opposing the direction of the current flowing. So we should take for net torque due to the EMF and the induced EMF will be I net into B A square upon 2. What is the value of I net? I net is equal to I is E upon R minus what is the induced current will be induced EMF induced upon R. What is the induced EMF when a conductor rotates in a circle like this? The standard case, if a conductor rotates in a circle where there is a magnetic field going down, the induced EMF is B A square omega upon 2. This is the induced EMF. Separate derivation can be done. We should also remember this formula. So put the value of induced EMF here. So I net is equal to E upon R minus B A square omega upon 2 R. This is the value of I net. Put the value of I net here to get the net torque due to the currents flowing through the conductor. So T net, I am repeating, is due to the current only. Due to the current. It is not the final net torque by taking into consideration mg also. So this becomes B A square upon 2 into E upon R minus B A square omega upon twice R. This net torque due to current flowing in the conductor should be equal to the torque due to the weight, so that the net torque is zero. For that, the angular acceleration will be zero, so that omega will remain constant. So this should be equal to mg A sine theta upon 2. So this is the relationship we are getting. 2 gets cancelled here, A gets cancelled here. So E upon R, also multiply this by R, so R goes here. So E becomes is equal to R M G sine theta upon B A plus B A square omega upon 2. This is the value of EMF, and if you take 1 upon 2 BA common, it becomes twice R M G sine theta plus B square A cube omega divided by twice B A. This answer is not matching with the answer which is given in the book. But if you test it in the book, it is given B A square. But that should not be the case, because if you compare the dimensions, compare the these two things, it will not match. Let me show you. Since the EMF induced is B A square omega upon 2 when a rod rotates. Forget this case, simple case. B A square omega upon 2. So the units of E and B A square omega should match, which is matching in our case. This unit of E is matching with B A square omega. But if you make it A omega, the answer will be correct, but the units will not match. So our answer is not matching with the answer of the book, and this is how the position is. But there is no other method, in my opinion, to solve this problem. And moreover, if you get A square here, then it will not dimensionally match. Moreover, the resistance is also missing from the answer, but the resistance has to be there, otherwise the units may not match. So that solves the problem. Thank you.